Hello, everybody. I'm Anie with JOOLTOOL, and on today's show, I will show you how to prep your bezel pushers. So these are two brand new bezel pushers, and I have one in brass and one in stainless, and I'm going to show you guys how to clean them up and get them ready to use. They're brand new, and this would be the same method you would use. Like, after a while, if yours got like dinged up and not as smooth, you would follow the same method exactly what I do today. So welcome to the show, you guys. I have a few announcements on new products that are on our website and are live with limited quantities. So I just want you guys to know this is what I'm going to be working on today. Yes, before I get started, I'm going to talk about new products. I know, you guys, I'm a little late. I'm a little late, you guys, on coming on here. Sorry. Work got in the way of my life today, darn it. And I was ready and early and everything, but it's just one phone call, one email. Take care of this, Anie. Before you go live, do this, do that. And before you know it, the time slipped. But I said, you know what? I'm still going live. I'm not going to let today pass me. I have a plan of what I wanted to do and what I wanted to announce. And I see everyone is trickling on in. So you guys, today I am going to work on a stainless and a brass bezel pusher. So we're going to, so these are two brand new ones, and I'm going to show you how to prep them for their, so they're ready to use, and what methods to use when you need to spruce yours up. So let me say hello to everyone, and we're going to get started, and I have some quick announcements to make. Hello, hello, everyone. Woo-hoo-hoo. Welcome to the show. It's going to be a fun show. Of course, it's always a fun show. Okay, so we've got, wow, look at all these people that trickle on in. Hello, everybody. We've got, can I go back to the screen? Yara keeps moving the screen, and I'm like, okay, so can you go back to the beginning? I want to say hi to everybody. Okay, hi. Hey, Bonnie's the first to come in. Hey, Bonnie. Hi, Nancy, Georgiana Chan, Adelmo, Deborah Smith. Hello, Anne and David Keith. Hi, everybody. Karen Miller Anderson. Oh, Karen Miller Anderson. Yay. I'm so excited you're here, and I hope you are doing well. I've been praying and rooting for you, Karen, and I'm so happy that you're doing well. Yay, I'm so excited. And we've got Ellie Grossman, welcome, and Kathy Wart, Melanie, and Carrie Hedge, and Melanie. Well, that's Terry. Hi, Terry. Hi, Vicky Hart, Teresa Sarnowski, woo, woo, woo. And then Suni, hello, Suni, and Janice Creamer. And Suni, I want to say a big thank you. I didn't get a chance to send you a message, but thank you so much for helping another sweet dear customer to helping Lauren choose a JOOLTOOL kit. So thank you. It means the world to me, Suni, and you just are rocking. I love you. You're just wonderful, and I'm so grateful and blessed to have you. Thank you, Suni. Yes. Hi, Janice. Oh, I already said hi to Janice, but hello, hello, Aaron. Hello, all the way from, hello, Anie, she's so cute. Hello, Carol Bartra. Hello, Karen, Carol. Andelmo, you're in Colombia. Yaro just posted a link. Look at the link that is in the comments. JOOLTOOL.com. Suni gave me kisses. Okay, so you guys, I'm going to work on the bezel pushers today. We've got a stainless and a brass, and I'm going to show you guys how to modify them to however you like. Okay, I'm actually going to do the most basic, but I'll show you what finish to get, how to get it, all that. And one real quick, a few announcements I'm excited to make. Okay, so you guys know that yesterday we launched the soft fine scratch eraser. If you guys missed yesterday's show, it's a new scratch eraser that we just added to our collection, our family of scratch erasers. So it's these two. It's a soft fine. They come in 4-inch and 3-inch right here. So these will allow you to conform into like pits, dimples, texture. Like we did this one yesterday. We did the whole bangle and we polished even in the texture without removing the texture. Don't ask me how that was. Yeah, you can show it above. So we did that. It came out really pretty. And then we also cleaned up. Hey, do you have my earrings? Oh, here. So we also cleaned the back of this where it had the earring post and we polished that up and it's very curved and it got into all the little uneven dips and whatnot. So these are really great to have in your arsenal. I have limited quantities now. You guys went crazy for them yesterday. So just so you know, we're on the limited quantities for the, so these are the soft fine. Okay. And then wait, we have already put on our website the mini versions to the soft fine scratch erasers. And these are it, you guys. They're so adorable. So this is, I can show you a demo, but I don't know how much I can do. Maybe I'll show it tomorrow. Okay, I can show you guys overhead. So this is the new 3M scratch eraser in the soft fine. So you guys, just so you know, there's a cushion to them. I'm gonna try to do it with my nail, but they conform. Do you guys see how they conform? Hold on, let me go up closer. Do you guys see how they conform? So if you have like an area that it's like round, this will conform and become like curved and just be delicious to get into hard to reach areas. But they're just, they're, the construction, you guys, of these are, hold on, let me show you the big one. So the construction, you guys, so it's soft and cushiony. Do you guys see that? But the way they're constructed is, of course, made by 3M, and they're designed to last. So they have the same, I guess, structure of all the other grades. You guys see that? But since, so this is not as easy to squish. Do you guys see that? This is actually the very fine. But the soft fine, you see how you can, how it's cushy? You see it's cushy? Ooh, look at that. Same with the, you guys see how soft it is? It's very delicious. So that's that. So we have the minis available for those now. Again, the minis, you guys, will be in a few days. And they are also limited quantities because I wasn't sure how that would go. But everyone asked for it yesterday. And now I'm like, crap, I should have ordered more. So it's okay. 3M is still in business. We're good. This is something that we have. And I just wanted to make sure we were able to get it before I showed it. The new, you guys, the new, very fine mini scrubbies are in the house. Available now. Also limited quantities for these. So they're available in the double, the dual layer, or the single. And they're just delicious. They're the very fine of the 3M scrubbies. And again, these are going to last you a good long while. These are the 3M ones and they don't disintegrate. So I see the minis already ordered. Mine, Melanie, you're so cute. Yes, I posted on the JOOLTOOL community and on my Anie Jolie and on JOOLTOOL, the links to where to find these, you guys. They're all at introductory prices. I just want you to know, same with the mini soft fine 3M scratch eraser. So, okay. Any other questions before I start? Yes. Hold on. Wait, let me answer some questions. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Okay. So just trickle on any questions you guys have. I see some coming. Oh, yes. Yeah. So you guys, Teresa just commented something. And Teresa, I don't think it's going to happen. So since there has been such horrible weather and no electricity in Texas, that's where Francesca Watson, my co-host on my Sip and Shine show on Thursdays, which is tomorrow, she's located in Texas and has had no power for the past few days. And I don't think we're going to do a sip and shine show tomorrow because I hope she gets her electricity and has time to, you know, catch up with everything. Because just imagine one hour without electricity and we freak out in the house. Just imagine, it's been days now. So my heart goes out to everyone affected in Texas because it's just ridiculous what's happening over there. I feel so bad for everyone. So thank you, Teresa, for mentioning that. Yeah, okay, yes, Suni, yes, Yaro, can you comment? Okay, Suni, Yaro's going to comment that. And then Melanie said something. Are the soft vine also going to be in the torpedo and bullet shape collection? I'm going to tell you guys right now that the soft vine will not be in that collection. You know why? Because it's soft, and if you try to make this in a torpedo, it'll probably, you know, be too flexible. So they don't offer it. Yeah, it defeats the purpose. So no, I can tell you with certainty that the soft fine in the minis are only going to be available in this shape. Okay, that's it. They won't make them in any other shape. So there. Thank you. That was a good question, Melanie. Thank you. Aw, you're so sweet. Teresa says she's sending warm thoughts to everybody. Okay, so back to our bezel pushers. You know, I'm going to ask you guys a question. Do you guys want to see the bezel pushers, or do you guys want to see how the minis perform? I don't know. Yeah, hold on, Kristen. I'm still on the topic. Hold on. Perfect. Okay, so Melanie already ordered. Beautiful. Good. Beautiful. Okay, so no one's saying anything. So I should do these? Okay, I'll make a decision. Well, I gave options, Yara. Options? Women love options. Don't you guys all love options? I'm a woman that likes options. Okay, we'll just continue with these. So I have a stainless steel one and a brass. So we're going to... Yeah, Melanie. Well, that was Terry. Terry will always put me to work. Do as planned. I love you. Yeah, they want... Hi, Linda. Hello. Welcome. Okay. So, you know what? If I don't get to the minis, I'll probably do those tomorrow. So let's stick to the plan and do the bezel. So you guys, I have a stainless steel bezel and I have a stainless steel bezel pusher and a brass bezel pusher. And on today's show, we're going to show you how to prep these so you're ready to use. So let's get started. All right. So you guys, since these are kind of long, you can use the 4-inch to get these dead flat. You guys see that? Because they extend out further. You can still do it with, let's say, your 3-inch, but you're going to have to kind of work at it at an angle. Do you guys see what I'm talking about? And you're going to have to do that. So the best option is going to be using the 4-inch size. Since I have them, I'm going to use them. So this is a wonderful opportunity to say the 4 inches work beautiful for this particular need. So what I'm going to do, you guys see how they're just rough when you just get them. They're not bad, but I don't want to put those up against a nice bezel because it'll mar it. You see there's scratches and stuff on it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure it's even. I take a look at it, you guys, to make sure nothing is, it looks like it's a little higher on this side. You see that? And so I'm going to, when I use the scratch eraser, I'm going to primarily work on this edge. And then, what? No, people know what a bezel pusher is. If you guys don't know what a bezel pusher is, it's basically to push a bezel in. You just rock it. Just keep it in and you just push it in. There you go. Okay. So let's go ahead and mark this. So what I'm going to do, you guys, is I'm going to darken the entire surface so I know exactly where I'm making contact on the wheel. There. Now, you can taper the edges down. Some people like the edges tapered. Some people like crisp and, you know, nice and sharp on the edges. Francesca Watson likes them sharp on the edges. So maybe we'll do one sharp on the edges and the other one will taper just to satisfy everybody. Okay, hold on. Okay, so what you do is, you guys, you're going to have to hold it straight and let the wheel work, and you're going to follow. So basically, I'm going to hold it up against the wheel and just rock it back and forth. And that's all you need to do. So we might clean up this space too. So, and now that I look at it, you guys, it's quite wobbly and not even. So let's do that. So you guys, a lot of people have, who's asking that? Okay, so I'll answer that question. Teresa asked, why do I have two different metals? It's some people prefer using the brass, it's softer, and some people prefer using the stainless. So I wanted to have both here to give you, you know, your options. And I didn't want people to say that, oh, will this work on stainless? We're gonna do both of them, so all the bases are covered. So that's the reason. Stainless is harder and the brass is softer. Okay, so let's get started. So I went ahead and darkened the sides and the top. Do you guys see that? So the side right here, I didn't notice this before, but it's really wonky and not as flat as I want. This side seems to be better, but this side is not. So instead of using the scratch eraser, I'm probably going to grab my 120 grit. There you go, my 120 grit purple, and I want to sand it down. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold it flat up against the disc, and then I'm going to drop it. You guys see that? So let me put my fingertip on. Let's put them on. Okay, here we go. All right. So I'm going to run this at medium speed because it's the 4-inch. Got my lights on. So I'm going to hold it here just lightly. You guys see? So I'm going to go nose down. Yara, can you do a side profile? I'm going to go nose down, and I'm going to gently lift up. So you don't want to lift up too much and round the edge. So we're going to go nose down and lift up. So ready? So we're nose down. See, when I make contact, I hold it nice and flat. You guys see how nice and flat it's getting? Oh, now we're even. There you go. Look at that. That's good enough right now because we're going to go over it with the scratch eraser. And I just did it very lightly, so I didn't compromise the thickness of the rocker. And we're going to hit it on this side too, just lightly. This side's not so bad. I just want that edge to be nice and crisp. You know what I mean, guys? Hold on. Yeah, this is a bumpy one right there. So we've got that edge. And now the top, I don't want to grind it because I don't feel it needs to be, you know, ground down. So I'm going to grab my scratch eraser in medium, you guys. This is medium. The reason why I'm choosing medium is because medium is going to be much more rigid. You guys see this? So it doesn't have too much give. It'll give me that really nice, flat, crisp edge that I'm looking for. So the medium, you guys, is great for, you know, going from a rough grade. You guys hear how rough that is? A 120 grit. And I'm going to smooth this down with the scratch eraser. So again, it's best to go ahead and darken it again. So you guys know exactly where you are, and it'll not, that by doing this, you guys, it will prevent you from, you know, rolling that edge over, because we don't want to roll that edge over. So I'm going to use my index finger to support it and hold it up. So I'm going to hold it again, nose down, and pop it up flat and just hold it there and zhuzh it in a few different directions. Same on the other side. So let's get started. I'm going to run this at medium speed. And Yara, you can do a side profile. So I'm going to approach it like this. And then I'm going to use my index finger to hold it up against. And there we go. Just let me hold it there a little longer, you guys. Kind of work those deep scratches out. Just zhuzh it up and down. You guys see how I'm kind of zhuzhing it up and down? Kind of go up and down like this. Yara, can you do a side profile of how I'm doing that? Oh, perfect. There. And then when you're done, you guys, you drop it. And that's the finish you get. You guys see? And that's enough. You don't need to go to a crazy high polish. That is perfect. Nice clean edge right there. You guys see how crisp that edge is? It's beautiful. Now we're going to do the other side and then we'll do the top. So here we go again. There we go. Just hold it. Try not to do anything. Just hold it flat and just wait for it and kind of work the little scratches out. You know, don't push. Just hold it there a few more seconds. That's the secret. If you're impatient, pushing will not help the situation. But holding it there a few more seconds will totally get the job done. And you see how crisp that is? Now I'm going to do the top. So to do the top, I'm going to hold it as close as I can to the Jewel Tool machine and literally go up directly. And now I'm just going to roll. There you go. And you can do it like this too, you guys. You guys see that? So you can do it like this, but when you get dead center, you got to kind of roll it like this. Kind of like a little pendulum. I'm going back and forth. And you can hold it in this, whatever feels comfortable. And that should do it, you guys. You don't want it to be too... Oh, that looks really good. And if there's any other area you missed, go ahead and put some more black on marker and then hit it one more time. And just do it slow and pay attention that you're nice and even during the process. There we go. Perfect. Okay, so here we go. So let me show you guys what we've accomplished. So look at how perfect and even that surface got. We didn't compromise the crispness. Do you guys see that? Everything is still perfect. And that should be it. So the reason why we're not going to a high polish is because you don't want it to slip. If it's high polished, it'll slip. But if it has a little bit of a matteness to it, it'll, you know, grip better. And it will not leave any kind of surface scratches behind because it's so smooth right now. You know what I mean? But it's not smooth to slip. So for example, like, you know, if I was doing a bezel, this is not a bezel, but it's a prong. And if I wanted to push this prong, which I'm doing it wrong, you would just go like this and push. You see how I was able to hold it? And there, I'm pushing the prong down and I didn't really slip. You see that? But if this was shiny, you guys, it's going to be like going loo, 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 all over the place. Mind you, I'm on a disc pushing with a bezel pusher. So if I had a better little holder, this, I can go up against the bench, but it's okay. Hold on. Let me hold it. There we go. Oh, yes. Dude, I'm not strong enough, but it's there. You guys see how it's not slipping? But yeah. So I'm very pleased with this finish. It looks fabulous. Look at that. Just take a look to see what it's supposed to look like. And there you go. Let me just get rid of that black. Hold on. There was some Sharpie left behind and I want it to look good. You can always do the sides over again. So you want it to be, I guess, smooth and almost smooth, matte. And not leave any, you know, and once it's smooth and matte like this, it won't leave any, you know, marks behind. It won't mar the metal. And that's what you want. So there. So this is a bezel with the sharp edges. So Francesca Watson was telling me she likes it with sharp edges. The reason why she likes it with the sharp edges is because she was saying that, because she uses this tool to compress the top of the bezel and the crisp edges gets her right up against the stones. And that makes complete sense. So if you want to go from the top and get as close as you can to the stone, then I would say leave the edges nice and crisp. No. And then, so this one, some people, so there you go. Let me go back. I know you're always like, where am I going? So the stainless steel one, you guys, I'm going to do it. So how many of you guys out there like the edges to be tapered, not sharp? Talk to me. And if enough of you guys say you want it tapered, I'll taper this one. So talk to me, people. What are we doing? I'm waiting. Should I be the new host of Jeopardy? I'd make a good host. I wouldn't know any of the answers except if they had to do with beauty or entertainment. I would answer all of those. I would know the answers to those. And it's funny too, when we watch Jeopardy, you guys, while I'm waiting for the answers to come in, when we watch Jeopardy, it's so funny. I'll like have the answers to all beauty and entertainment. And Yara will look at me and goes, how did you know that? How did you know that? And I'm like, I'm good. And then they ask like some weird geography question. And I'm like, and Yara will come in, oh yeah, that's Zimbabwe. And I'll be like, okay. I know. Sorry. Love you, Alex Trebek. Okay. So I have tapered my stainless one. Bonnie, how did I know you were going to say that? Honest to God, I was channeling you with the bevel. Yes. So let's, so that's what I was going for, you guys, having the steel tapered. So guess what we're going to do? We're going to taper the sucker. We're going to taper the stainless steel. Yes, yeah, so I'll answer Debbie's question right now before I get started. And so while I'm doing this, you guys, if you have any questions, type them in. And then when I'm done, I'll answer them all. Even if it's not really related to the bezel, I'll help you guys out. So what else do we got here? Which one? Oh, Debbie Broussard. Is this what you use to get rust off of the tools? Sorry, I had to look under. Yes and no. So what I just used right now was the medium scratch eraser. You can use this to remove rust, but primarily I like to use our scrubby wheels to remove rust. It just depends. If the surface needs to be very clean and the pores, you know, the pits from the rust and stuff, anything remaining on the metal needs to be smoothed down, I would use this. But initially, so I don't get this rusted, you know, I don't get this, you know, messed up with rust particles, I will use my scrubby wheel, which are the following wheels, real quick, to answer that. So for rust, I highly, highly recommend our scrubby wheels. This is the same family that I just said that the mini very fine is in stock. So it's the 3M scrubbies. Yeah, I hope this helped answer that question, but I definitely, and oh my God, you guys, Suni posted a die that she cleaned up from rust on our JOOLTOOL community page, and it is gorgeous. She did use the scrubbies for that too. So thank you, Suni, by the way, for that amazing post. It was gorgeous. And the pan, I missed the pan. Suni, I got to check out a pan. They're telling me you did a pan too. Apparently she did a pan and they are all like, but I'll just tell you, everyone was oohing and aahing over what you posted, Suni, yesterday. Congratulations. Good job. Okay. So we're done with that. Let's keep going. So no. So the vote is in. The stainless steel one, I am going to create the taper edges and refinish the top. Yes. Okay. Perfect. Thank you guys. And I will commence. So here we go, you guys. So when we say we're going to taper, I'm going to put this, a pot, not a die. A pot. There you go. All right. Thank you, Suni, for clarifying. So what we're talking about when we want to taper the edges. So this one, we want to taper the edges. So basically this edge right here is where I'm going to grind. Do you guys see that very edge right here? Because not everyone likes these sharp edges. Do you know what I mean? So I decided to have two and then we'll do this one. So again, I'm going to show you guys how to taper this using your jewel tool and not a hand file, because I see so many posts out there with a hand file. Now, listen, if you don't have a jewel tool, you guys, you're going to have to do this with a hand file sitting at the bench. So you're going to take your hand file and go, hink, crunk, hink, crunk. Just follow that roll. Your arm, your shoulder. And you know, my shoulder isn't doing good these days. So why would I do that to myself? Why would you put strain on yourself? I certainly do not want to go back on that bench, hunch over and go, because that's what I'll do. Hope you're laughing because that's funny. I think that's ridiculous what I just did. Okay. Well, there you go. Welcome to my show. Oh, nice. Carol's back. Carol says she got to watch this time. Hi, Diane, Molly. Yes, sending you warm water. Bonnie laughed, lol. Okay. Hi, Paula McDowell. Yes, Paula, usually tapered, but Francesca's suggestion makes sense if you use the pusher on the other orientation. Hi, my sister Laura's watching. Hi, Laura. She's in Colorado right now. Okay. So, you guys, so the first thing at hand is we are going to taper. So even though I'm going to just do that edge, I'm going to darken everything. And this will, I'm going to actually put this behind because you can see better. I'm using my polishing cloths. So there. So this will allow me to get a nice taper, even though it's not quite well finished. You guys see how it gets narrower here, but whatever. What do you want? It's not like the most expensive pusher in the world. So let's make sure we do that. So I'm going to go back, you guys, to my 120 grit. Is this it? Yeah, my 120 grit purple ceramic. Okay, see that? Now, with this, you guys, you definitely can use your 3-inch, okay, on this particular step. But since it's so much easier with the 4-inch, we're going to stick to the 4-inch. So this is what I will hear. Before I start, wait, hold on, let's go. Let me talk again. I'm going to do a fake roll. So you guys see right here, I darkened this surface, and I'm going to taper the edges on the each side right here and right here. So how I'm going to do this, you guys, is I'm going to hold the tool. I want you guys to see how I'm holding the tool. I'm using my pinky as like a stability base, a little foundation to kind of hold. I'm actually holding the wood part with my left hand, and I'm pinching the top neck area with my index finger and thumb securely. And so from here, I'm gonna find my little nice little angle because I can see through the disc, and I'll show you guys how I determine that. And I'm just gonna gently roll without pushing. And when I'm done, I'm just gonna drop it. Okay, no sliding off the wheel. So let's get started. So since it's a 4-inch wheel, we're running this at medium speed. There we go. Put my vacuum on. And so again, I'm gonna just start all the way at the end and see where I am. Do you guys see that? And so you can make one quick pass. It doesn't have to be perfect in the beginning, but just do it slowly. Kind of hold each section at the same time. You see that? You can kind of roll over it again if you want, depending on how tapered you want it. And then when you're done, drop it. See that? Let's see what we did. Oh my God. Look at this. So the longer you hold it in a particular position, the wider the bevel is going to get. You guys see what we just did right there? You guys see that? So honest to God, this is so fluid that this is difficult to do even with a hand file. We machined this. So do you guys see what we did? There. So now I'm going to do the same on the other side and smooth them and then bring it together with the scratch eraser. You guys like that? Okay. Yeah, so if this side was lumpy, you guys, I would have just touched it up with like the scratch eraser real quick. you know, or maybe even the 120 grit like I did in the previous step. But this one seems to be better finished than the brass one. So you never know. Each manufacturer. Yeah, probably because it's harder metal. I bet you, Yara, the other person went crazy grinding. So again, same position. Put my pinky here. I'm going to grab it with my index finger and thumb, holding it securely with my left hand. And I'm going to hold it at an angle. So this is how I determine. You guys see how I'm determining? I'm like, that's wide enough. And then you just keep going slowly. Slowly is the secret. Slow and steady wins the race. You guys, honest to God, we can go over it one more time. Look at that. Oh, it's just lovely. When you go over it again, that is crazy. You guys see that? I mean, this is just too fun to do. Like, look at that, you guys. So now, since we just take a look at it and we're like, okay, that's a little even. I told you it was a little wonky to begin with. And if you want to pull in more bevel on one side, you guys, you can. Other than that, this will all blend together just fine with the scratch eraser. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to grab the medium scratch eraser and I'm going to blend all of this. Yes, it's a custom tool now. Right, Tom? Hi, Tom. So I'm darkening it one more time, you guys. And I'm going to use the scratch eraser. And so this step with the scratch eraser, I'm going to use the medium again. What this will do is allow me to now take those sharp bevels and just round them over and clean the surface. So I'm actually going to hold it here and kind of blend them all together. So let's get started. So again, running at medium speed. So I kind of start my footing on one of the bevel and kind of roll it over a little. You guys see that? Let me show you. So now basically we're rolling over the bevel just a little. Just a little, not too much. Just a little. You don't want to go too much, but just enough so it doesn't scratch. So let me show you guys what I did right now. Can you guys see that? So do you guys see how I still followed the bevel, but I slightly rolled that sharp edge over? Just that little taper. You see that? So I'm going to do the same. So it's a sharp edge. So you follow the bevel. You guys see that? You follow the bevel, and then you kind of bring it in just a little and knock that little sharp corner off. So here we go. So again, I'm going to start at the end. So here you are on the bevel. So we're on the bevel. And then you just kind of roll it just a little bit to get rid of that sharp edge. Do you guys see that? There we go. There. And then I'm going to roll that little sharp edge over. There. Perfect. Oh, this is how I would like my bezel. You see that? And now that center is nice and flat. And we're just going to keep it like that. And just go over the flat surface once with the scratch eraser. You guys see how perfect and detailed that is? Look at that. Very nice. So now we're going to go more like I'm going to hold it here a little and do that. Hold it here and then hold it straight and go down on the middle area. So let's get started. Again, run at medium speed because it's a 4-inch. If you have a 3-inch, you run it at high speed. So we hold it here. So I'm holding it down center, nice and even. So remember, this isn't grinding, it's burnishing. So it moves the metal. Metal is malleable. So that should do it. So this is what I did right now. I want to show you every step so you guys can see it for yourself. Do you guys see that? Just one pass, you guys, and it left a beautiful finish. Now, if you want to roll the edges just a little bit more, you can. And if you do, I don't think I need to, but if you do, let me show you guys how to just touch it up just one more time. Kind of just give yourself a little black, maybe on the other side too. I don't know. I think we're okay, but just in the event that you need to, but this is how what you do. Because this is not about how Anie could do it. This is if you run into this issue, You know, this is how you do it. There we go. Oh, it's just beautiful. Look at that. You can see that? And then now I'm going to do the other side. Just one more, like a light little pass. If you think it's a little too sharp, you know what I mean? You just pass over just lightly. Don't push hard. Pushing is going to be your enemy. So if you don't push hard, you just go over it a few times. That's your answer. Pushing is not your answer. Oh, this came out good. Oh, it feels like butter. So good. So good. So look, you guys. So this is so nice and even all the way on top. You guys see that? We got the taper. You see the taper? Nice. Follows the light beautifully. Same here. Now you can roll over it more, but I still like that area to be flat. Do you guys see what I mean? Can you guys see that? I want that top to be flat because you want that area to be flat. Of course, when you're pushing a flat bezel, you know what I mean? A nice flat. I don't have a bezel. Do I have a bezel? Basically, it's kind of like, this is not the right one, but you get what I mean. You want it to be flat to rock. That's what the whole idea is. You're going to rock that baby. Rock the boat, baby. Rock the boat. And we didn't make it too shiny. And if you want it more dull, you guys, just hit it with a scrubby. How about that? And it won't mar your metal. So you guys, yeah, it won't change the shape. So if you want it a little bit more matte, use like your fine scrubby. I like them like this. They're nice and they're not high polished, just enough matte so there's not slippation and it won't mar the metal. Did that work? So what do you guys think? Looks good, huh? So we were able to do, aw, thank you, Carrie. So we were able to do both the stainless bezel pusher and the brass. Now the stainless, like you saw, we did the edges. We brought down the edges and we tapered them. And this one we left nice and crisp. And this is what I mean. Let me go ahead and put this here. So this one has the sharp edges. You guys see that? Nice and crisp. Nice and crisp. Remember, that gets closer to the stone if you want that sharp corner. Or this is the stainless steel one where we put the little bevel on it, the little edge right there. You know, that'll prevent anything from scratching. And we still were able to maintain a flat surface. And that's what you want to keep. So there. Looks great, huh? I like the way these came out. Give it a little polish on the sides. Sure. Wonderful. There we go. Okay. All right, you guys. So that concludes the bezel polishing. I used, just to recap, I used the 120 grit purple ceramic in the 4-inch. That was this one, purple. Then I followed with the scratch eraser in medium in the 4-inch. Which is still on my machine. And so I basically did these in two steps. Yeah. They're available. So this is the medium and this is the 120 grit purple and they're both with the 4-inch. So there you go. And it works on any bezel or pusher, really, you guys. It's just, it pains me when I see people use a hand file and are just going at these things like they're digging for gold or something. It's like, dear Lord, how much are you filing off of your poor bezel pusher? So I know you guys can't relate because you guys all have a JOOLTOOL who's watching, but those who don't have a JOOLTOOL, you guys saw how fast it was to grind. You can grind anything, grind edges, you know, off of your ring, things that you just don't like. That's how fast it is to grind. And this was stainless steel. So just imagine how beautifully it grinds, silver and brass and gold and all that stuff. And same with platinum and titanium. So I hope that answered all your questions. But now is the time where I'm going to answer all of your questions that you guys typed in. So what do you got for me? Talk to me, baby. Talk to me. All right. So I'm going to look through the... Oh, they're riveted with what I did? Okay, Bonnie. I don't have the deep of the taper on mine. I think I'll re-taper it. I love you, Bonnie. You know what? I like a little bit more of a taper. So you can go deeper on the taper, Bonnie, as long as you maintain that top part to be nice and flat. You know, I still have a nice flat, but the tapers, if you slip, are really nice to get rid of. You can even have, we could have even pulled down the sides completely. And this is what I mean. So take a look, Bonnie. Like, let's say that I wanted to pull the bevel even more back in the event that I'm a slipper. You know what I mean? I just slip no matter what. So you guys, you can definitely pull this part back. You guys see this corner? This is what I mean, this corner. So it would be just this little edge right here. And I'll show you guys how to do that. You guys see that? There. So I'm actually not going to grind it. I'll just use my scratch eraser to blend and move the metal because I just want a little bit of, you know, a rounded edge. Not as sharp. Yeah. So let's go ahead and do that. Again, giving myself good stability with my pinky, holding it tight with my index finger and thumb. I'm going to hold it kind of flat and kind of give it an angle. So that very edge right there, look at that. I'm just going to knock that edge, that sharp edge down. Oh yeah. And just bring it all together. There we go. And you guys see how quick and easy that was. So it doesn't, oh, it's like, oh my God. So it does not have any sharp edge at all. You see that, how it kind of rounded over? And so we still have that flat at the top. We're just making sure that the edges don't cause any trouble in the event that there was some slippation. There we go. So I primarily concentrated just on that very edge. Oh, this is just delicious. So the edges are nicely tapered and rounded over, but the center is nice and flat. We did not compromise. So this is what I mean by the flat. Look at how the light is following the top. It's nice and flat. That's what I mean, you guys. That's what you want. You need a flat top so that it uses the flat to push the bezel, thus calling it a bezel pusher. Bezel pusher. Bezel pusher. I'm going to call someone that. You know, you're just a bezel pusher. It sounds so mean. I love it. Yes, that's another part. Yes, slippation is in the JOOLTOOL dictionary. You like that? It's slippation. You know, the slip. It happens, you guys. It really does. It happens to the best of us. So we've got two bezel pushers completed on the JOOLTOOL today. One tapered and one not tapered. So hope this will help you guys. Once you get these, you know, they're nice to have around. I know a lot of people have them. Even though you have like a hammer hand piece, these sometimes solve the issue when you need that extra little something and it's a delicate stone. You're not sure if you should use your hammer handpiece for that corner. This is a great alternative, you guys. Trust and believe. Okay. So again, for everyone that's tuning in, just so you know, and don't say that I didn't tell you that, oh, it's gone. Of course I drop everything. See how quick they're going? I swear. We have the new mini very fine scrubbies available in limited quantities in the house. So we've got, oh, we got them in both dual layers. We got them in the double layer and in the single. So we have all configurations and they're just delicious. Really, I'm so excited. I can't wait to use them. So I'll probably do them on tomorrow's show. And we have the soft fine available in the minis. So these are up on the website right now. And these are great. I repeat, great to conform into hard to reach areas. This is going to be a good friend to have. And I get, again, you guys, I will be getting them only in a few more days and limited quantities as well. Already, they were up yesterday and a lot of them sold. Yes. Oh, Carol says, you make my day with your smile and all your help. Thanks so much. great lesson. Good, you guys. I'm happy. Someone's telling me real quick, you guys, can't wait to try the soft. Yeah, Paula, the soft. Yes, Bonnie, I got to confirm with Danny Wade on tomorrow. So, but most probably, maybe we'll get him on. So hopefully, he's a hard one to catch, but he's ready and willing. He said that my army already is bugging him to come on my show. I love hearing that. You guys, that's you guys. Get him, guys. Ooh, 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 I love it. I love it. Yeah, we're strong. Okay. Yes, so I'm waiting for that. But let me show you real quick. Someone's asking how they work on another page. So hold on. Let me answer. So look. So you guys, they perform like this. Where'd they go? Where'd they go? Oh, here it is. But let me try the other one too. I want to show how they work. Okay. So you guys, the soft ones just have a flexibility. I'll show you real quick how they perform. Look, yesterday we did this bangle just to give you an idea of how they get into areas. They're really nice and they conform without like destroying the detail. Do you guys see how it got into the texture? And the texture is still alive and well, which is crazy. And it gives, like, people will say, how in the world did you clean that up while still maintaining such fluidity? And you say, well, I have good tools. And then we showed how to clean up anything that's like a dimple that'll conform, anything that has like a little dip. You see how it got that dimple without flattening it out? Same with this one right there. Real quick. It has some sponginess to it. I can't explain it, you guys, but it's just, it's. And we did this whole area yesterday, you guys. There was like a post here, and we ground that down and smoothed it. Do you guys see how fluid that is? So that's why these are very nice to add to your arsenal. You never know when you'll use these. And again, you guys really got a lot of my inventory. So they're limited quantities now, but they're available. We still have stock on them, and they're available on the website. Your cult army, Diana Schnitzka. I love you. Yeah, I know my cult. Don't even get that's still lingering. Carol, you know what? It'll probably be around 12:30 tomorrow, my time. But I will post when as soon as I bug Danny right now. More like groupies. I love you, Irene. I know. But he referred to us as the army. And I'm just telling you, quote. Yeah. So you guys, I will post in the JOOLTOOL community what time and when I will be on with Danny Wade. Sounds like a plan? Sounds like a plan. Okay. Awesome, you guys. Well, on that note, I will see you guys here tomorrow. It was so lovely seeing you guys, really. You guys made my day, and I hope this was helpful. If there's anything else you guys want to see me do, please let us know. Because this was a request by a few people. And so since the request was out there, you know me. I'm here to serve and help and protect. No, kidding. Yeah, so thank you guys again for helping those who need help in the JOOLTOOL world. I thank you. I honor you. I respect you. And I appreciate you. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. And I love you. Mwah. Mwah, 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 mwah. Take care, you guys. See you tomorrow. Bye.